It's really interesting to me how Charlie's revelation and his journey affects the people closest to him in his life, from his mother and his father and his immediate family through to his relationships with his friends. Because Charlie is a 14-year-old boy, and everything that comes with that stage of your life, you know, the football and the kind of testosterone and everybody kind of kidding each other about and joking, and the slightly kind of tough environment of school is one thing that obviously he has to deal with his revelation. And but for the family, for the mother, for me it felt like it was really important that we had to try and relate that she is grieving for the loss of her son at the same time as welcoming the birth of her daughter. And that's a very complicated place to find yourself, particularly as the father in the film finds it much more difficult to support Charlie in his journey. Oh, soccer plays a massive part in the movie because it was a brilliant device by our writer, Peter Machin, who was able to use this device of Charlie being a brilliant football player. And what his mother does in the film is she coaches a female football team so that he can continue his passion. And then there are new relationships to be forged within that and challenges as well, because obviously some of the women in the team, some of the girls in the team, are very anxious and angry about Charlie's introduction to their team. But also, using football in the film, it's such an exciting sport, and there's so much passion involved in the sport anyway. And you know, parents on the sidelines are always emotional about football, regardless of who's playing. So it was, I think it was a really good idea to weave football into the story of Charlie's transition as well. So the question of how LGBTQI people are treated in England, particularly with regard to education of children around these issues, I think we are coming along. I think in the last few years there's been a huge leap forward in people's understanding and acceptance. Maybe that's naive of me to think that, but I feel that there are more people in the public eye now who can tell their stories. I think it's incredibly important that children are spoken to openly and sincerely about these things, because it should never be felt to be a secret or wrong, or, you know, I think we should really try to work towards total acceptance, of course. And that begins with education and being able to talk to children sincerely and openly. Children aren't stupid. They know when you're hiding something or when you have a strange attitude towards somebody, and I think it's our responsibility as parents and adults to talk positively and engage. I feel very lucky to live in London. We have a very multicultural local community with lots of different people. At my children's school, there are 27 languages spoken. And so for my children, what people look like and how they sound is unsurprising. And I hope that we can work towards sexuality and transgender issues in the same way. I think it's fundamentally important.